Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, knowing the abasement of your Son, have raised up a fallen world. Fill your faithful with holy joy for all those you rescued from slavery to sin. You bestow eternal gladness for our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Or sandals, or walking stick. The laborer
deserves his keep. Whatever town or village you enter, look for a worthy person in it, and stay there until you leave. As you enter a house, wish it peace. If the house is worthy, let your peace come upon it. If not, let your peace return to you. Whoever will not receive you or listen to your words, go outside that house or town and shake the dust from your feet. Amen, I say to you, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah on the day of judgment than for that town. The Gospel of the Lord.
And when we look at Christ and child. Notice, that's fulfilled literally and then figuratively, symbolically. One out of a place of slavery and darkness, confinement, no freedom, the beleaguered life that they held for 400 years. Think of the pain of those parents. That's a reflection, that's a meditation for the day. See, your child is born, but you're a slave. You have no freedom. And now your child is born. Joy and lamentation at the same and one instant. You are born a slave, my child. Think of the pain, the sorrow of those parents, generation after generation after generation. Out of Egypt I brought my child. So the Lord, by strong, mighty hand, liberates them. Then when Jesus arises, it's the irony of irony, he has to flee from Israel back into that place of darkness that was Egypt. And so when Joseph and Mary and the child fled because of the persecution that was unleashed by Herod, he fled. So second time, I called my son out of Egypt, brought him up. Then he came, and sisters and brothers, Egypt for us really now symbolizes the slavery of sin. God is still summoning his children out of this darkness, out of this place, to give them a place of peace and true prosperity in the Lord. So, symbolically, again, if you can see that the house that Jesus speaks about, we can do this literally, yours truly, I do it all the time now, and it took years for me to get it. So when ever I'm invited somewhere into someone's house, I would say, peace to this house, God bless you all. And if a peaceful person there is there, it will remain. If not, this is really what Teresa of Avila will tell us. It's the actual interior castle. It's the house of you and me inside. If there is a peaceful person there, the peace of Jesus Christ will remain. Peace I give you, not as the world gives, do I give. Not as the world, but as I give. Peace I give you, my peace I give you. We pray every day in the Mass. For he is still summoning us out of Egypt, and he wishes to therefore bestow us peace. This is the mighty exchange of God to take us out of darkness and bring us into his wonderful light. With the sentiment of a parent, and if you know what you feel about your kids, blow that up now. Now you understand the love of God. God bless you. In the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
For those riddled by anxiety,
Lord, give them solace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the young people in our community, may God stir in their hearts a deep love and reverence for Him. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may the perpetual light shine upon them, and may they rest in peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Now in silence, please take a moment and offer up your own petition. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Merciful God, you have loved us truly as Father by lifting us up to your cheek. We pray throughout the ages that your unfailing goodness may give answer to our prayers with your compassion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God, all creation, for your goodness, and every sweet wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
And Lord, accept the sacrifice of your hand. For the praise of our Lord and name, for our good and good of all this holy church.
May this oblation dedicated to your name purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the light of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy. Through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior, Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and aiming for you, a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection, so with the angels and saints we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim, holy, 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 Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth, full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. And humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Ronald, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, O people.
Thank you.